Avril, Purim, Purim! Fire it up! Ani! Shalom Aleichem, the covered Purim, Arik, Yafarkane in the house, Tamar, Avikarkowski, Shalom, Shalom, Chevre. Oh, and the Kinderlach as well, anyway, for Purim. Chevre, today is a very special day. Number one, post Kriyas Megillah, post IDC. Little JLIC party. It's geschmack. It's geschmack. And we just have to reveal the secret that it's our 2-year anniversary in this group today on Perm. 2 years ago, we sent the first link on Google Hangouts. It was a other chat called Short and Sweet Torah. That was the Stealing Torah before the Stealing Torah. I don't know if you guys remember it. And now we transitioned to Stealing Torah. So 2 years ago today, we sent out the first link. And now a lot of links later, we're here. We're mamash here. Baruch Hashem for giving us the ability to try to be consistent, to try to grow together, to smile together, to have fun together. Mamish in Omavanda, in Omavanda. And we're able to experience it now, now that it's Purim, and we've been learning about it for so long. In Omavanda. Tfila Bashim Kol Yisrael. For Herman, Svi, Marco, Pesach, Uvim, Ben Yosef, Asara, Baruch Abbas, Yehudis, Miriam Dodi Bas Chanu, Chevin, Yonah Bas Basa, Shir Bas Basa, Satner Uvim, Bamani, and every Neshama in Klai Yisrael should have a refuah, whether it's physical, spiritual, or mental, or any other issues, mamish every single neshama in the world, shalom kira. Ribono shalom, have pity on one who's so far away. Therefore, we have come before you, Hashem, my God, and God of my fathers, to appeal to you. We are willing to call you from the ends of the earth. Loving God, have pity on us. We are so far from you. We feel so rejected. It's as if we've been driven away. Through the power of your love and mercy, bring us closer to you. Call a halt to our troubles. From now on, start drawing us closer and closer to you. You've let us know through the teachings of your sages that your greatness is most revealed when those who are furthest away come generally closer and begin to serve you. Bezrat Hashem, I may be completely distant from you. Even so, please do not treat us according to our sins. Don't judge us according to the wrong we have done. Even when people are far from you, you are near to them. Wow. Did we do halacha l'maisa last night? I don't know if we did halacha last night. I think we got a little too excited. So I think we forgot the halacha. We're supposed to do Ad L'Yada. The whole, the halacha's there. But we'll do it tonight. We'll do it tonight, Chazara. B'Shem Kol Yisrael halacha l'maisa. The Gemara says that a person is obligated to drink Ad L'Yada bein Arur Haman the Baruch Mordechai. The mitzvah to drink on Purim is related to the mitzvah of the Suda. The mitzvah is only during the day. There is no mitzvah to drink at night. Now, there is a lot of parties going on right now in Israel. And the drinking, we can't make a mistake. It's not a mitzvah. It's not a mitzvah to get drunk tonight, however it is tomorrow. The Ramah says that you can fulfill the mitzvah by drinking a little more than you normally drink and falling asleep. Then you surely won't discern the difference between Arur Haman and Baruch Mordechai. If you normally don't drink and aren't really interested in starting, then on Purim, drink a little bit and go to sleep. The Mishnah Brura says that it is proper to follow the Ramah on this. A couple more halachos. Rosfi Pesach Frank explains that according to the Ramah, the mitzvah is not to get drunk per se, but to drink. And once you reach the point that you don't know the difference between Arur Haman and Baruch Mordechai, you are exempt from the mitzvah of drinking. Sort of like last night, you drink slowly and slowly until you reach that level, until you reach that awareness and ability. Right? It doesn't mean go further with 15 million other drinks. I'm giving muster myself. I'm giving muster. Ribbono Shalom. Ribbono Shalom. By falling asleep from the drinking, you would also be exempt since it's also Adelei Adah in a sense. Wow. One more. Rav Shlomo Zalman Orbach rules that a yeshiva student who is forbidden by his parents to get drunk may not get drunk. Rather, he should father Ramah Mishnah Brura. Wow, good to know. However, we're always in yeshiva. We're always in yeshiva. We're Shana forever. We're Shana forever. We all know. Chavra is very fitting. We all know it's Purim, but it's also our 2-year anniversary being together in this Chabura, coming and seeing each other every single night. For most nights, mitzvah of increased simcha, though. Yes. Yes. Kira, so good. So good.
You're saying about the night, like that we have to be careful not to be confused. Stay away from the night, but you know, when Adar is increased simcha on Purim, it's Kodesh Kodashim, simcha b'simcha. So, in a sense, like there, I mean, of course, there's always different avenues. Ilacham al Maim should be the main one. But wouldn't that be a reason possibly that some would find to drink in the night as well, to have the an ensuring the increased simcha?
That is a great Shaila. Wow.
No answers. Answers are
that's good.
Positive questions are active.
So good. So good. So Chevra, we're gonna learn Samach Aleph, Lukutei Etzos, Rav Nasan, the last piece of Torah I learned with Rav Yair when I was Shana Bet, which inspired us to start stealing Torah together and to learn together. And as you see, Farkane is in the car. Don't know where he's going, but he's stealing Torah. He's Baderech. Jordan Bellows, maybe my apartment, may not be Baderech, and he's still stealing Torah. Kira's in Toronto, getting ready for Purim, has so many preparations, and he comes on stealing Torah. A week before with his kids in the car, every single night, we're able to see what it really means to steal Torah in such a positive way. Rav Nasan and Samach Aleph says, Sarich Adam Lachtof V'Ligzol Itim LaTorah Mitoch Atrada. A person, Chevra, we have to take mamash with force, steal Torah in those times during the day when we're, you know, in the middle of when we have a period off, or we have 15 minutes break in between classes, when we have lunch, when we're on the bus, when we're on the train, when we're in business, finding ways to steal Torah. We mamash have to be active. Kira just mentioned a second ago, questions are active, answers are passive. We mamash have to activate our senses with force, be physical, steal the Torah. Ki afilu mi sheyesh lo asakim utradot rabot. Even if there is a person who is busy and feels like he's busy for 24 hours, right? I have to study for 24 hours. You know those chavra. I mean, I can't speak because, you know, I'm not in the same program as those chavra who do say that. I could be in a much lesser and less demanding program. But those chevra who say, I got to study for 24 hours, 25 hours. Farkane is on the way to Jerusalem, right? He has a long car ride, right? I don't have time for Torah. I don't have time for Torah. No. Chevra, we mamish dafka during those times, we have to steal. Afal pichin, iev shar shalo yuchalach tov filigzol la'atzmo. Even though it's impossible that you're not able, right, to steal and to take yourself, but this is a wrong translation. Even if you believe that it's impossible to steal and take Torah, and to steal Torah to learn some Torah, there's not one moment in the day where you can't. We have to leave off with that question. End off with that question. Is there not one second we can? Now, Chavra, like I said before, like I'm going to repeat myself now. I mean, just seeing all the smiles, seeing all the different backgrounds on Zoom, all different places in the world. It's not like we're in a Beit Midrash, right? We're always on the move. We're more baderech. We're outside the base. Kira's in college. Farkas in college, Bell's in college, we're all going by Derech, right? We're all connecting to one. We're all connecting and remembering one. No matter the background, we're finding time to steal Torah. Bezrat Hashem, we should continue to steal Torah together. Have Hitchachu with our learning, right? We could say we've done this for 2 years, but that could bring us to a place where, you know, we feel like it's towards the end or things are stale. No. Chavra, this is mamash the first day of stealing Torah. This is the first day of stealing Torah. The Kavod Purim, in o mevado, questions, comments, please feel free.
Fire it up.
Fire it up!
Wait, so are you able to hear me? Or?
Yeah, we can hear you.
I thought of something that I shared. I don't know if anyone saw it already. But I was just thinking, like, you have to get drunk enough to know that you can't tell the difference between Haman and Mordechai. But you have to be sober enough to know that you can't tell the difference anymore. Just a little joke for tomorrow.
Farkane is so good. Farkane, wow, Gavalt. Love that. Kira, you've been to share. Bellows.
Bibles. I'll tell you from the new book, from the YU book fair, one of the new books. But so says one of the concepts, you know, the classic idea. No way. We got two. Golden square. It says like in the Megillah, like when the Jews were spread out amongst the land, right? One of the classic things is, right, this meant that the Haman realized that the Jews were spread out internally as well. But they weren't connected, they weren't cohesive, they weren't unified in one. They were spread out amongst the land, right, all over the place. Each Jew in a different place, mentally, in addition to physically. And this is what he wanted to take advantage of. You know, he wanted to realize that they don't have that power of unity. And this is the time to attack, right? This is the time to go in and try and divide even further, take advantage of the division. So that's why he said, that's why the combat was Esther telling Mordechai, go in and gather together all the Jewish people, right, for the fast day, which, you know, I'm in the midst of now. Jack has already experienced in history now. And is looking forward at counting down the days till get another opportunity. But, right, that experience, she said to him, go and gather the Jewish people. And again, it didn't just mean physically. It didn't mean go and just tell them, right, that this is what's going on and this is what you need to do on a physical level. Saying go and gather together the Jewish people, round them up into one. You know, let's reunify the chevra. Let's figure out what it means to be whole again. to have one God, you know, one nation, Am Echad, B'Lev Echad, Ke'ish Echad. And so I think it's the, is it the Brisker? Let me just find the name so I don't misquote the Rav here. It's one of the craziest concepts that only really he could say. We wouldn't be able to say it here. So the first concept, by the way, the reason why it catches the eye, it's from Shlomo Alkabetz. We know the Kabbalistic master of all of Lecha Dodi. So he's the one that kind of points out that idea of the unity and division, meaning those things. So the Klausenberger Rebbe. Klausenberger Rebbe says something so crazy. So he was in World War II, right? And he says in the concept of unity, the Klausenberger. So he's Jack's best friend. Wow, that's crazy. Is that the one you were telling me about? That's the one. Okay, I didn't even connect that. But so listen to what he says. Maybe you already read it, but says when describing the horrors of the Holocaust, he says there's actually one thing that he missed from those years. Like he appreciated it in a way. He says, when we would go on the death march, we were all clean shaven and our hair was shaved off too. This is word for word. We marched side by side and no one knew if the person next to them was a chassid or a litvak. No one knew that I was a rebbe. We all just held arms around each other and tried to keep ourselves and our fellow Jews warm. And he says, this is unity does not mean that everyone has to think the same way or that has to see the world in the same way. He says specifically in a religion that claims to be truth seeking, you're going to hope that not everyone's thinking the same way or else something is very terribly wrong. He says it's even healthy for it to be so. He says we have to realize we're one family. Where all the family members disagree, but we all love and respect, even when we fiercely disagree with one another. And keep this in mind, we surely warrant Hashem's protection, he says. And I think it's really the idea for him, stealing Torah and all of Am Yisrael, really just come together in the disagreement. You know, the 12 tribes, like we always said in Yeshiva, there's never just one tribe, always at least 12. Who knows how many tribes there are today. We have to appreciate that. Love that, respect that, recognize that. And with that, go into Purim and just fly with the Hamantashen.
Wow.
You hear it, sir.
There's someone for now.
Chasidim Sochakim Mizeh. Wow. Refruman. Akira, that was powerful. We need to hear that from the Klausenberger. We need to hear that. Wow. Mizrat Hashem. We're going to reveal another secret now, right? The first secret of that, it was, it's the 2-year anniversary of the Chabura. But the second secret, if you go to the channel, we already have our first video out. It's 30 days until Sukkos. I kid you not. Kid you not. 30 days. What we're trying to do together.
Till Sukkos or Pesach?
Till Pesach. Till Pesach. Thank you for the correction. Till Pesach. Right, we're yearning for redemption. And essentially what we're trying to do is get 30 different rebellion personalities that we all look up to. And hopefully they could send a short video of themselves talking about a short idea on redemption on Pesach. And we'll post it each and every day. And that will be our Hachana for Pesach, part of the Hachana. Every single day, watching a different video. We reached out to Rav David Aaron today, Rosh Yeshiva of Oraita, and he sent us back a 2.5-minute video that he actually posted 5 years ago. So we reposted it, and we definitely have more big rebbeim that we look up to coming. So Bezrat Hashem, we should all look forward. We should all be, we should all just check the channel. I don't know, should I post it to WhatsApp or is too many things going on?
Send it through?
That was such a secret, fellas. Send it through. Just punch the phone.
The Chevra needs it. Send it through.
Chevra, Bezrat Hashem. Be well. Be well. So our first video is out tonight. And Bezrat Hashem, we'll get one tomorrow. Let's just pray.